Bubble sheet assignments allow instructors to predefine the correct answers for questions on multiple choice exams on an answer key. Gradescope can then grade the student's multiple choice responses automatically. Bubble sheet assignments are available as part of our Gradescope Complete product. So to start, let's go to our course's assignments page and click Create Bubble Sheet Assignment. We'll give the assignment a name and select that instructors will be the ones that are uploading submissions. From the answer key page, we can download the bubble sheet template, which looks like this. This is the template that we'll print and distribute to our students. For the best results, it's helpful to tell students to fill in the bubbles of the correct answer or answers completely using ink or dark pencil. If the bubble sheet assignment has multiple versions, students should make sure to bubble in the exam version in the version region at the top of the template. To build the answer key, we select the bubble or bubbles of the correct answers for each question. For questions where multiple bubbles are selected, we can choose from three grading styles, depending on how we want full or partial credit to be awarded. Finally, we can set the default point value for each question up here. If we want to set a different point value or grading style for a specific question, we can override that by clicking on the cog icon next to the question. And if our bubble sheet assignment has multiple versions, we can repeat this process by adding up to 5 versions of the answer key. Once we're done, let's save our answer keys. And we're now on the Manage Scans page. So here is a scan of 8 students' bubble sheet submissions saved as a single PDF. Note that each student has identified the version by filling in the bubble for version A, B, or C on the template. We drag and drop this PDF onto the Manage Scans page. Gradescope automatically splits the pages in the PDF into submissions and assigns each submission to a student and to a specific version on the Manage Submissions page. Since this is an assignment with versions, any submission that did not have a version selected are flagged for us to manually assign them to a version of the answer key. If we go to Grade Submissions, we see that Gradescope's AI has automatically graded most of the students' responses. If Gradescope's not certain about some of the marks, they'll be flagged as uncertain marks. We can review all of the uncertain marks from the top of the Grade Submissions page. So all of these look good, and we can confirm them. All submissions have now been 100% graded, but if we wanted to adjust the rubric or add more feedback for any question, we can select a version, click on the question name, select grade answers, and adjust the point values on the rubric to give partial credit to certain bubble options or to add custom feedback. Adjusting the rubric for one student will update it for all students for this question and version. We can publish grades to students and/or export a CSV file of all of the students' responses for all versions from the Review Grades page. And from the Statistics page, we can see the reliability value, standard error of measurement, and standard deviation score for the assignment, and a mean score for every question. We can also tag questions with concepts, learning objectives, or any other custom tag, and then view statistics by tag. Finally, if we click on Item Analysis, we can see the breakdown of students by percent that selected each answer option, and we can also see discriminatory scores for each question. Discriminatory scores help determine how well each question discriminates students with knowledge from those who were just guessing. Questions with a discriminatory score below 0.20 are flagged for additional investigation in the Insights panel at the top of the page.